So let's hear Rahil speak on the latest.
So thank you so much, ma'am. And that was a wonderful presentation, Bharti ma'am. So again, we are talking about how ray tracing is superior to the topography guided treatments in LASIK procedure. So I've been using the WaveLight Plus platform for ray tracing and the Contura platform for topography. And it's a 3-minute debate, but I can conclude this in 30 seconds. Contura or topography-based refractive procedures have been the most popular in the last decade, and now this technology is upgraded. So whenever the technology is upgraded, it always improves on the existing shortcomings. How is it improved? I'll go step by step. 30 seconds, only 3 points to be discussed. Level of customization. Whenever you are doing a topography treatment, your customization is limited to cornea. You are only correcting the corneal higher order abrasions, and it is working on a gold standard platform. You take Schwinn's topography or you take customized, they are all working on a standard one fit all gold standard model. But now with the latest ray tracing introduction, we are making an individual eye model for every patient. Now it is not a one fit all treatment, it is a tailor fit suit. Now we are not just adjusting the sleeves, the whole suit is being designed, the whole treatment is being designed according to the eye model of the patient and not the gold standard model. Coming to the point two, better quality and better quantity of vision. Topography guided treatments can give you supervision 6-5 effect in only 10%. Here in ray tracing, we are giving 98%. The advantage of 6-5 supervision, 40% C6-4 and 8% C6-3. That is almost double of what a normal person can see. Better nighttime contrast, better depth of focus, overall better vision quality and quantity. Point number three, like we were talking, future changes with the changes of abrasions in the eye. The new treatment WaveLight Plus is future ready. So they've already incorporated the changes which will happen with the healing process of the eye, epithelial remodeling, biomechanical changes already incorporated. We are able to predict the outcome of the surgery before even we do the surgery. So pre-surgery also we know the outcomes, and post-surgery your vision is maintained for a longer period of time. Now it is not like the older generation procedures that you have the best quality vision the next day, and as the years pass on, you tend to lose on the quality. So I think the only reason why somebody would want to maybe opt for an older technology would be the cost.
But we need to move on in technology, and fair enough, we have something which can be offered to people who want more than 6x6. Practically 6x3 is not required.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
Eagle's eye or whatever.
Yes, so exactly, that is what I want to highlight here.
Those people came 50% time down.
So it's not
selective, yes.
So it's not for hypermetropia, it's not.
Yes.
So we move on with a new technology up our sleeves, we need to master it. But the thought process of the technology is very valid.
I think the biggest highlight, if I have to say, leaving us aside the debate, that now we are shifting from the gold standard model to an individual eye model. So I think that is one of the biggest upgrades that has come to the refractive surgery.
Biggest drawback is it does not capture.
Ma'am, it captures.
50%
it
does not capture.
No, it captures 100%.
So they said, "Ma'am, leave it. Why?" तो मैं हमने तो सारा इसको काउंसिल कर दिया कि हमारे यहाँ तो इनोवाइज आ रहा है तो बोलता नहीं मैम इस पे तो मैचिंग नहीं है ना सब्जेक्टिव से
सेइंग दैट यू विल हैव टू ऐड ऑन दिस मशीन बट नॉट रिप्लेस
20% यस
सो द डिबेट इज
एंड यू कैन नॉट टेल पेशेंट्स कि आप इसको कराएं क्योंकि आप इसको कन्विंस कर देंगे और फिर आएंगे तो फिर क्या हुआ मैम हुआ क्यों नहीं तो
डिबेट इज वन बाय भारती मैम Debate is won by Bharti ma'am.
The take home message as an audience and a refractive surgeon is this. You need the machine so that 20% of your patients do not go off to Rahil Chaudhary.
As it is, sare ke sare ja rahe hain, to wo 20% ko pakad ke
le liye you need that machine. The good news is, he's only talking about WaveLight. So he's lost out on 80% of his patients. Because he's only talking about
20%
and getting the best.
But we need the machine for that 20%. So
I wish it was vision more than the engine failure, which could have led to not having a crash.
Yeah.
But that was the vision of somebody else who just switched off the fuel tank, which I'm hearing is the sabotage. So we take it that the technology is a welcome. We need to be very, very cautious at selecting the right patient, giving more chair time, as always we have taken that as a message. And also the fact that why not? We are so open to technology. Don't we debate on cataract conventional versus femto? Yesterday when I was opening this as a debate, there were so much, sudden assault on the fact that femto should go back, femto machine should be taken away. But do you really think like that? Femto for grade 3s and 4s are done superbly well. We are all witness to it. So that really gives you a confidence. So the fact that was here, Dr. Bharti is a win-win.
Yes.
And so is Dr. Rahil.
Thank you, ma'am.
For introducing new technology always.
Thank you.